Resport and Export Gold proudly present an all-star night of basketball magic. Everybody, it's time to get pumping because the man's in town. Welcome to our three-sport basketball special tonight, live and exclusive from the ASB Stadium in Auckland, a night that promises to be simply magic. I'm Clint Brown, and it's great to have you with us tonight. Well, tonight, for the first of two nights, Irvin Magic Johnson is going to lead the Export Gold American All-Stars up against the AMI New Zealand All-Stars for the first of two games over two great nights. And for 12 years from his amazing Rookie of the Year performance back in 1980, when Magic Johnson led the LA Lakers to the first of five NBA championships, to his retirement in 1992, he's become one of the all-time greats of basketball, a man and a player who has earned the respect of all the stars of the NBA.
Because of the HIV virus that I have attained, I will have to retire from the Lakers.
Magic's just a great basketball player. He's the best I've ever seen.
The perfect demeanor. Tough, confident, winner.
He embodied all the attributes of what it takes to become a great, great player.
Sometimes you dealt some bad cards in life, and you got to play the hand out. You can't quit, and you can't stop.
Trying to educate other people. That's giving of yourself, giving up a lot of yourself. I think the kids are gonna learn from that.
Yes, just one of the many magic memories we'll be reliving tonight, live and exclusive here on 3Sport. And I guess for sports fans all around the country, for you sitting at home, and especially for the basketball fans, it's a great chance to actually sit back live in your living room and see why Johnson earned that nickname of Magic, why he won the MVP three times in the NBA Finals. In his career of 874 games, he averaged 20 points per game, 12 for assists. So why would a living legend, one of the world's great athletes, put on a cap that says Magic Down Under and come on down to New Zealand to shoot a few hoops?
I've enjoyed the 12, 13 years that I played. I'm enjoying my tour now that I'm on, getting a chance to come here in New Zealand play. People never see me play live, so that'll be fun, I hope, for them as well as for myself to play here against the national team or the all-star team that they're going to put together. So I'm having fun going around the world, going to places that probably I never would come to if it wasn't for basketball or this tour. So I'm having a good time.
And I can tell he's not the only one. He's out for a good time tonight. Almost a capacity crowd is packed in here to the ASB Stadium, getting ready for showtime, a bit of slamming and jamming. And I can tell you that seats are still available for tomorrow night's big show. And of course, they are available at Bass. By the way, they range from $100 to $75 down to $35. But two guys who managed to burgle their way in for free tonight are your commentators on 3Sport. John, I'm going to go off the planet. Didvig and Tommy, nothing but net Hyde. And guys, I suppose for all the B-ball fans out there at the moment, they're just saying to themselves, I can't believe that Magic's actually in town.
Yeah, that's right, Ken. I can't believe that. I can't believe my nickname either. But it is a remarkable evening. And John, I'll tell you what, we've not only got one of the greatest NBA players of all time here, but it was apparent from his press conference yesterday that we also have with Magic Johnson a great human being.
Oh, exactly, Tommy. I tell you, in my wildest dreams, I never thought I'd see Magic Johnson in New Zealand. But you're talking about a guy that stopped the Barcelona Olympics. He's here. He's going to play. We're going to see a great game tonight because his pride and integrity won't let his team slack off. You know, it'd be interesting to see how the New Zealand kids stand up to that athletic pressure. Besides Magic Johnson, you've got Reggie Theus, outstanding player, used to play for the Chicago Bulls. You've got Mike McGee, unbelievable talent. It'll be interesting tonight.
All right, there we have the word from the commentators tonight. As you can see, the players are standing behind me, getting ready for the introductions to the crowd. And of course, it's also going to be a special night for the All-Star National Anthems. Watch out for the American guy who's been living in New Zealand for the last 6 years. You may remember him as the bass man for the Commodores for over 25 years, Ronald LaPred. He's going to be singing the American National Anthem in just a moment with his good friend Larry Woods, and also Michelle Sadgrove singing the New Zealand National Anthem. But for the New Zealand players, well, how do they feel about tonight's big game? It's a big ask to actually go out there and beat the American All-Stars. For them, it's going to be just the chance to actually say, hey, I've played against Magic, one of the idols of the NBA. To find out who the All-Stars are, let's meet the teams.
For your entertainment tonight, the New Zealand AMI All-Stars at number 4, Chris Tupu. Plays guard for Canterbury. At number 5, Ninad Vucinic. Guard for the Nelson Giants. Ralph Lattimore at number 6, plays guard for Canterbury. Eric Brown at number 7, 5'10" guard from the Auckland Stars. Byron Vaitoi comes in at number 8, plays guard at 6'5" from Hawke's Bay. Darren Shaw at number 9, plays forward for the New Plymouth Bears. Ricky Strother, another local boy from the Auckland Stars, at 6'10". Neil Stevens, number 12, is a forward with the Auckland Stars. Peter Porkai with his new club this year, the Otago Nuggets, at number 13. At number 14, Lamar Jackson, playing centre tonight at 6'8" from North Harbour. Kerry Bowagny at number 15, plays forward at 6'7" for the Hawks. And your captain tonight for the AMI New Zealand All-Stars, number 10, Glenn Denham. In the white strip, the Export Gold American All-Stars, Reggie Fox at number 2. Played in the CBA for Grand Rapid Hoops. At number 7, Lester Connor. He's guard at 6'4", a draft pick of the Golden State Warriors. Derek Martin at number 15. He's a guard at 5'11". Marshall Henry at number 18. Plays forward at 6'6", played professionally in South America. At number 22, Stephen Thompson. He's a guard at 6'3", a CBA Rookie of the Year. At number 23, Earl Cureton. He's a forward at 6'9", a member of the 1983 NBA champion Philadelphia 76ers. At number 24, Reggie Theus, a guard at 6'7", drafted by the Chicago Bulls. At number 25, he's John Long. He's a guard at 6'5", a member of the 1989 NBA champion Detroit Pistons. At number 40, he's Mike McGee. He's a guard at 6'5", a team member of Magic on two Lakers NBA championship teams. And at number 32, he's a guard. He's 6'9", a key member of 5 Los Angeles Lakers NBA championships, a gold medal winning USA Olympic Dream Team member. He is Irvin Magic, Magic Johnson. Ladies and gentlemen, if you could all be outstanding for the national anthems. Firstly, the American National Anthem, and this is sung by Ronald LaPrey, an original founding member of the Commodores. He'll be followed by the New Zealand National Anthem, and that'll be sung by Michelle Sadgrove.
So proudly we hail as the twilight lies gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars drew a perilous line. Oh, the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the New Zealand national anthem by Michelle Sedgrove.
Take a short break live and exclusive here on 3 Sport. When we come back, we'll have tip-off, that magic moment in the Export Gold basketball magic. Stay with us. Welcome back to 3 Sport. This is the scene live and exclusive here at the ASB Stadium in Auckland. Great to have your company live around New Zealand. If you're sitting back in your sofa at the moment, we are getting ready now for the first big showcase of exhibition basketball with the Magic Johnson All-Stars up against the Tall Blacks, the New Zealand All-Stars. To check on those starting lineups, here are your commentators, John Tidbeck and Tommy Hyde.
Thank you very much, Clint. We've got a nice shot of our stadium here. Our starting lineup, not on your screen, but for the Magic. There we are, the Magic Johnson All-Stars. John Long at guard, former Detroit Piston. Lester Connor, he'll be another guard. Reggie Theus, former Chicago Bull. Earl, the twirl curtain at center. And, of course, the Magic man himself. John, give us the New Zealand starting lineup.
Well, the New Zealand starting lineup, Tommy, is American guard Eric Brown. Guard Ralph Latimer from down in Canterbury. American forward Kerry Boagne. Glenn Denham, the captain, down from Otago. And then Peter Polkai, also down from Otago. So it'll be an interesting lineup there. You look at Magic Johnson's team, he's got more runners. In fact, his whole team is a team of runners. And some of the New Zealand kids are a bit on the heavy side. So it'll be interesting to see how they match up.
It's been a long summer for some of the New Zealand kids. And you say they're a bit on the heavy side. A little bit too much turkey over summer, I think. We've got our tip-off just about underway in, John, what must be one of the most historic moments in New Zealand basketball. This is a terrific moment.
Yeah, this is amazing. As I said earlier, I mean, Magic Johnson stopped the Olympics. He's here, he's playing, and it'll be real interesting to see how hard he runs. I think, you know, his integrity as a sportsman won't let him ease up. So the New Zealand team will be in tough tonight. They're not going to have an easy one.
Here we go, ball goes up. Kerry Boagne, tip goes to New Zealand's Ralph Lattimore. Eric Brown, Kerry Boagne, looking inside. Ralph Lattimore at the top. Boagne, Boagne, first shot of the game, not gonna go. Rebound, John Long, Magic moving it up quickly, as is his style. Reggie Theus, first shot of the game, nice baseline jumper.
That's gonna be the problem, Tommy. They're gonna run and gun. They're gonna fill lanes because Magic's gonna get him the ball, and if you don't guard him, they're gonna score.
Magic inside on Peter Polkai. Outside, we've got Kerry Boagne at the top, being watched by Earl Curtin. Glenn Denham, first time he's handled the ball tonight. Ralph Lattimore, three-point shot. No. We have a foul.
Okay, first foul on Peter Polkai. Probably a little unfortunate, you know, because he's going to have to try and use his bulk, because the Magic Johnson All-Stars are all good athletes. They're all jumpers, and they're all big, big shoulder guys. So there's going to be a lot of fast breaking tonight.
Age of experience also with them as well. They're very, very court-wise when they play this game. Reggie Theus out front looking for a shot. Three-pointer. Yeah, no. Rebound. Look at that. Earl the Curtain with a rebound. 4-0 to the Magic Johnson All-Stars.
Yeah, it's going to be tough for them. They're going to have to box out.
Just under 1 minute of play gone. Eric Brown looking for a shot. Not going to penetrate. Kerry Boagne with a bomb. No. Peter Polkai, the rebound.
All right, Boagne's going to have to hit, though, if this heel is going to have a chance. Inside move by Peter Polkai. I think he caught Curtin by surprise and took it right to him. Good on him.
Magic spins and twirls and runs into Peter Polkai, who's going to be called for holding.
One, five.
I should point out, Tommy, that we're playing 4 12-minute quarters. This is NBA rules, 6 personal fouls. They're going to get it up and down the court. It's going to be a little bit longer game than the New Zealand team are used to.
Where's Magic Johnson at the foul line? Our first free throw of the evening, 4-2 in favor of the Magic Johnson All-Stars. He makes his first, and Magic Johnson won his first NBA title in 1980. First rookie. He makes his second shot. Magic, the first rookie to be an MVP, most valuable player of an NBA final. Back up the floor with New Zealand, Peter Polkai inside, being looked at by Magic. Boagne going to get hot and heavy inside. No. Rebound, Earl Curtin. Magic moving up quickly, pushes it out. Lester Connor inside.
That's the problem right there. Open shot.
John Long from the corner.
These guys are such good scorers, you have to put pressure on them. Here's a man that's going to have to do it.
Ralph Lattimore in the corner. Reject. Gary Boagne heavily rejected by Earl Curtin. Polkai power play inside. No. Glenn Denham a rebound. And it's off Glenn Denham's knee.
I think one of the strategies you're going to see, Tom, tonight, the New Zealand team are going to have to try and slow it down just a bit. They don't want to get into a rat race with these guys.
Absolutely. A little bit too scattered for the New Zealand team right now. Kerry Boagne looking at Magic. Ralph Lattimore double team. John Long from the corner. No. Rebound Glenn Denham. Ralph Lattimore to Denham. Nice give and go. Rejected.
Foul number 23.
That's the other thing that the Magic Johnson All-Stars are going to have to get used to. He blocked the ball in the air, and he hit him with his body. In the NBA, that's not a foul. Here, it's going to be a foul, so they're going to have to adjust quickly. Otherwise, they're going to use their long bench.
Well, Glenn Denham to the free throw line for New Zealand. And they need all the points they can get. We've got 19:30 left in the first half, and it's 9-2 in favor of the Export Gold Magic Johnson All-Stars. Denham missing his first shot. New Zealand captain, Glenn Denham, misses his second. Magic Johnson moving it up quickly. Being watched by Agnew.
Nice.
Oh, nearly got through. Boagne. Kerry Boagne on a sprint. He's not going to get to it.
Now, you'll notice tonight, Tom, Magic Johnson's picked a good team. He's got a lot of veterans, as you said, and he's got a lot of youngsters, and they're really going to run the floor for him.
Boagne back in the action after that crumbling crash. There's John Long, can't make it work. Scramble, Magic, Eric Brown, Reggie Theus. No.
Reggie Theus has never been known as a three-point shooter. I think down under he's trying to make a new reputation for himself.
Well, it's evident that the All-Stars have not come out to play patsy tonight. John Long hustling Peter Polkai there, and they come back up with the ball.
And I think they got a lot of pride and integrity on their side. And I mean, they're attached to Magic Johnson, so they want to shine.
Magic inside looking for the outlet pass. John Long. Yes.
Going to have to guard him.
A trade for John Long
played for the 1989 Detroit Pistons, who beat the Lakers. He's a pretty tough player. I mean, most of these NBA players out here have played over 600 games.
12-2 in favor of the Magic Johnson All-Stars. Eric Brown for New Zealand. Peter Polkai inside along the baseline. Ralph Lattimore intercepted. Bad pass. John Long on the break. Ralph Lattimore, a follow-up.
Foul.
Well, I'll tell you what, Tom. I thought the referees let him get away with an extra step in there. Might have traveled before he got fouled. Yeah, he was on the track on that one. Maybe the referees are in awe too.
Referees are probably no doubt in awe for the first few minutes anyway. Now they're working up a sweat. Lots of running and gunning here. We've got 8 minutes, 26 seconds left to play. Magic Johnson, All-Stars 12, New Zealand 2. Here's John Long. John Long, 6'5", University of Detroit, played for 8 seasons with the Detroit Pistons.
We have one. There it is.
Some words from referee Ken Colson there. John Long makes his second. 14-2 in favor of the Magic Johnson All-Stars. New Zealand still looking for a good shot. Throwing the last two away. Ninad Vucinic now at the top for New Zealand. Peter Pokai. Maybe passed up a shot. Boagne going to take it? No. John Long out to Magic. Bounces off the head of Reggie Theus. Magic in the middle. Pulls up. Flips back to Curtin. Theus from the corner.
They outlet it to Magic. If the New Zealand team were smart, they put two guys on Magic and slow the baby down a bit.
Good comment. New Zealand back at the other end. Peter Pokai along the baseline. Boagne. Boagne drives, partially blocked. In fact, entirely blocked by Magic. Yeah.
As we mentioned at the top of the broadcast, Tommy, it's too much athletic skill.
Well, with 7:36 left in the first half and the Magic Johnson All-Stars leading 16-2, we've got a timeout.
Ah, do.
Number 32 for the Los Angeles Lakers. He was the biggest figure in American sport in all senses of the word. He really was Magic. And today's revelation was a national bombshell.
Stunning news. Magic Johnson is retiring from basketball because he has tested HIV positive.
Irvin Magic Johnson was arguably the greatest American basketball player of all time. He missed the opening rounds of this season because he felt unwell. Then a test revealed the true nature of his problem.
Because of the HIV virus that I have attained, I will have to retire from the Lakers today. I just want to make clear, first of all, that I do not have the AIDS disease, because I know a lot of you want to know that, but the HIV virus.
Johnson played for 12 years for the National Basketball Association, always with the Lakers, whom he led to the playoffs 9 times, including 5 world championships. His play was incredible. To crown his seemingly golden life, Johnson married his school sweetheart 2 months ago. Now his life has turned upside down.
I just want to say that I'm gonna miss playing, and I would now become a spokesman for the HIV virus, because I want people and young people to realize that they can practice safe sex. And you know, sometimes you're a little naive about it and you think it could never happen to you. You only thought it could happen to, you know, other people and so on and on. And it has happened, but I'm gonna deal with it.
Back live now, and our score hasn't changed. It's still 16-2 in favor of the Magic Johnson All-Stars. New Zealand looking for their second hoop. John, what's New Zealand's problem here?
New Zealand's problem right now, they're playing way too cautious. They got to kind of take it as it comes and take the open shot. They're playing a tough team. They're playing a team of athletes. You've got to take your shot, because if you wait too long, they're going to force you into a mistake. Now, the other thing is, they're real interesting. John Long and Glenn Denham are having a real good jawing session at the moment. John's trying to give the old psych job.
New Zealand retains possession. There's Denham and Long right there. Boagne going to take it? Yes.
That's what the New Zealand team have to have. They got to open it up on the outside. But there's that open shot from Long.
Glenn Denham with the rebound, 16-4. Eric Brown hanging on to a tough one there, looking for his first shot. Boagne going to take his second in a row. Yes!
Boagne!
That was interesting. Ken Colson gave the 3-point shot on that, but his foot was actually on the line.
It was on the line. Good call. Nevertheless, 16-7. Kerry Bewagney with back-to-back hoops for New Zealand. Look at, there he is, routing Magic Johnson right now. Johnson inside of the
rim.
No. Yes.
Man after my own heart. Little baby hook.
Earl Curtin follows it up with a nice tip in. 18-7 in favor of the Magic Johnson All-Stars. 6 minutes and 27 seconds left. Ninad Vucinic throws a brick. And the All-Stars throw it away. New Zealand going to retain possession.
It'll be interesting, Tommy, see how we go. We've only got half of the first quarter, and the New Zealand team is already grabbing the pants.
Well, as we say, maybe too much turkey or chicken or something over those barbecues over summer. Barbecues and beer. Ninad Vucinic out the top. Glenn Denham with his first three-point attempt. In and out.
I'll tell you, I'm pretty impressed with Big Peter Polk. I mean, he is taking up some space down there, making those guys work for it. I think Neil Stevens should get in there. He needs some help.
Yeah, well, to be fair, I mean, they are a new unit with the two Americans and then three New Zealanders. It's a very difficult assignment for these guys to find some kind of rhythm as a full team. It's going to be a lot of individual play.
Yeah, little pinch post here for Magic. Screen over the top, the old L.A. Laker play. Trying to get the ball inside.
Eric Brown comes up with it for New Zealand, penetrates to Denham.
Nice play. That's what they need to do. They need to take care of those opportunities when they come and then slow it up when they're not there.
Magic now on the side. Inside again. Inside too. Is it John Long gets it off the glass and is fouled. Nice pass from the Magic man.
I think what a lot of people don't realize, Tom, is Magic is at, you know, he's 6'9", so even if you're guarding him, he's bigger than you and he can throw over the top. He's got such great court vision because he's such a tall guy that can handle the ball so well. I mean, on the other hand, you look at Eric Brown, the New Zealand point guard, he's 5'11", he's 10 inches shorter.
5 minutes, 35 seconds left to play in the first half, 20-9. Here's John Long.
And maybe John Long's trying to make a comeback here. Maybe there's a scout in the crowd.
Well, he got around after he left Detroit. He played with Indiana, Atlanta, and then went back to Detroit. 21-9 now, favorite Magic Johnson All-Stars. Neil Stevens, his first look.
Yeah.
Oh, nice move. Rebound, Glenn Denham.
Glenn Denham.
21-11, Magic Johnson moving in quickly to the baseline. Pumps it up off the glass. No.
Well, Black. Push.
Oh, Neil got his first foul. I see that, you know, it's unfortunate on that, really. I mean, those are, you know, it should be white ball out. Not really a foul. Body contact is part of the international game.
Magic at the top, looking for Reggie Theus. Not going to go. Eric Brown comes up with it. He got a 4-on-2 situation. Bewagney bounce pass through the legs, and it goes off. Lester Connor, New Zealand, will retain possession.
That's an interesting, Tom. They're running plays down here. The Magic Johnson All-Stars are running a lot of Laker stuff, a lot of over the top. Go to the basket. That's good to see. They're not just coming down and firing it up.
Yeah. Well, we had a workout today. They were here 2 hours in the gym, and it was a well-organized workout. It wasn't just a light run. Magic was definitely in charge and putting him through some routines. We've got a jump ball.
It seems like the New Zealand strategy at the moment, Tom, is to shoot the three-point shot. You still got to give Glenn Denham credit. He's got to be the slowest non-jumping white 6'5 forward I've ever seen that gets his hands on so many balls.
Glenn Denham, I would say John pound for pound is my best player in the country, as they used to say about Sugar Ray Robinson. Glenn Denham, pound for pound, the best.
A lot of heart and guts, you know.
Magic Johnson with the tip, comes back with it. Reggie Theus goes in, blocked by Kerry Bewagney. Theus again off the glass.
Great block, great non-call, great second ever by Theus.
23-11 in favor of the Magic Johnson Export Gold All-Stars. The AMI New Zealand All-Stars. Here's Ninad Vucinic at the top. Glenn Denham in the corner. Bewagney. Vucinic. No, Bewagney. Vucinic was open for a shot.
They get that ball right now. Bang. John Long. Yeah, it's interesting, though. Magic Johnson, if you want to criticize his play right now, you can say he's not playing defense. He's not putting a hand on Bewagney.
Bounce pass to Vucinic, goes in, flips it back to Jazzman, and they lose it. I think Ninad should have shot that one.
Yeah.
Just like he should have got the ball for a shot on the last trip down the floor. 4 minutes left in the first half, 25-11. Here's the Magic man. Oh! 4-on-2 situation. Tupu pulls up. Yes.
Tupu.
Chris Tupu. Smallest man on the floor, a Canterbury Ram. Now looking after Lester Connor. Double team, Reggie Theus in the corner. Theus. Rebound, Vucinic. Boagne. Pulls up, jumper.
Pulls up. No hand up for Magic. I think you'll see the All-Stars start making some rapid substitutions now any second either.
Lester Connor. Good hoop from Lester Connor along the baseline, makes it 27-13 in favor of the Export Gold All-Stars. 3-12. That's 3 minutes, 12 seconds left in the first half. Denham in the corner.
Good cut by Neil Stevens.
No. Magic. Quick outlet pass. Lester Connor. Can't get it.
Nice.
Oh, yeah. Look at that.
Very smooth. Very smooth. You know.
Two in a row.
Good cut by Neil Stevens the last time down. Opened up the shot for Glenn Denham.
Neil Stevens in the corner being watched by Earl Curtin. Glenn Denham being looked after by John Long. Vucinic in the corner. Shot. No, air ball.
A little air.
Lester Connor comes up with it for the Magic Johnson All-Stars, and here's the guy down the floor. Does it, David Campese, and he's blocked by the Jazzman. And the Jazzman's not happy about it.
Yeah, no, I think he got a fair block there.
I do too.
Kerry Boway.
Let's have another look.
And here he is right here. He got the hand right on top of the ball. Hands part of the ball. That was a fair block.
Lamar Jackson.
Kerry's going out to take a ball. Lamar Jackson is actually in, an American that's been over here naturalized and playing as a New Zealander.
And he got a very nice welcome, a nice appreciative applause from the crowd. Here's Magic with his first free throw. And he puts it in, as Clint Brown would say, nothing but net.
Nothing but net, Tom.
Just like me. Magic with his second makes it 30-13 in favor of his All-Star team, most of them from California today. With 2:18 left in the first half, here's Nenad Vucinic. Byron Vitoe, Lamar Jackson wasting no time, can't make it go.
Out there, Tom, they really get that ball in the hands of Magic Johnson right now. He gets it in quick. Earl Curtin's going to throw it out. He's not an outside shooter.
Magic with a three-point bomb. No. Whoa, no. Neil Stevens with the rebound. Flips it out to Byron Vitoe. He's going to pump a three. No. Becoming a bit of a shooting match here.
Coming a little bit ragged at the moment.
Byron Vitoe.
That's a left-hand hook from Byron Vitoe.
Well, I guess as long as they go in, it doesn't matter what kind of style or form they come from. Here's Reggie Theus.
Behind the backboard.
Again.
Comes back with it.
Earl
Curtin. Earl. Nice. He played on the Philadelphia 76ers. Yeah. He's a tough inside guy, but he's actually a forward.
Earl the twirl Curtin. Here's Byron Vitoe. Daniil Stevens looking for a shot. Off the glass, no. Magic with the rebound. Coming down quickly. Got John Long out there. Lester Connor comes up with it.
Jump up.
Connor, jump shot. Yes, 20 sir. Feet, yes.
Oh, no rotation on that ball. That was an ugly looking shot, but it goes down. Probably, you know, one of the things these guys are going to have to adjust to is they're not getting much pressure on their shot, you know, and that'll throw you off. I mean,
well, there you are, 35-15. You saw our score, a 20-point lead for the Magic Johnson All-Stars. 50 seconds left. Here's Chris Tupu.
Chris, nice shot. Going around behind the screen, have the open shot, let it flow.
You know, I keep saying this time, 50 seconds now, 42 seconds left in the first half. It's not, it's the first quarter.
First quarter.
And once again, I think we should remind you that we're playing four quarters, Ryan, myself, right? We're playing four quarters.
Nice play.
Nenad Vucinic with a rebound.
Over the top for the Magic Johnson All-Stars. They're running some good stuff.
Tupu, yes. Well, the man on the floor right now is playing the best game for the New Zealand AMI All-Stars.
Came in and penetrated a little bit.
Byron Vitoe picking up Magic Johnson.
And the NBA All-Stars are kind of now playing NBA-style ball. Let Magic go one-on-one for the last shot.
Yeah. With 5 seconds left.
First quarter. You know, Tommy, it looks like Magic's a little rusty, too. I mean, he hasn't played.
Well,
in a while.
It's interesting talking to his agent today and telling me their agenda. They just have come down to New Zealand for these two games, and then they're going back to the States. And they, in fact, don't play a game. They play a game about every 3 months. They don't have a regular circuit, a regular tour. So these guys have got to continue to stay in shape in their off hours.
Which is tough. I mean, that's tough to do. And Magic does a lot of promotional work, so he's not out playing basketball. I'm surprised, though, they let this first squad go the whole 12 minutes without a substitution. I thought with the squad they've got, they would really run it. Maybe they're going to go two fives.
One.
Magic makes his second. Here's the final shot of the quarter. 3 seconds. 2 seconds. They may not get it off. Lamar Jackson. No. End of our first quarter of play. 36 for the Export Gold All-Stars led by Magic Johnson and 19 for the AMI New Zealand All-Stars. We'll be back. Back with our second half of play now, 36 to 19 in favor of the Magic Johnson All-Stars. Here's our tip. And they come up with it. New players on the floor now for the All-Stars. That was Marshall Henry. There's Henry again in the corner. Mike McGee, ex-LA Laker. Reggie Fox on a drive, and he slams into Lamar Jackson.
Takes it right down the gut. Looks like they're going to run a little weave there because they've actually got four guards in the center. They've got four guys, 6'5 and under, and then they got Cureton in there at 6'9, so they're going to really try and open it up a little bit, but I can't expect Magic to be off the court too long.
Well, there's our replay, and it was a real blast. Reggie Fox knocking Lamar Jackson to the floor and being called for an offensive charging foul in the process. Back with the action now, Nenad Vucinic inbounding the ball for New Zealand. Chris Tupu, who came off the bench and did well in the first quarter, runs it up, gets it to Byron Vaitoe. New Zealanders settling down here slowly. Lamar Jackson, Neil Stevens, Tupu, Vucinic, Vaitoe, yes!
Byron Vaitoe!
He got the foul on that, Tom, and actually, Fox is complaining that he pushed off with his free hand, but you got to give it to Byron. He took it to him. Tough baseline. There it is right here. You'll see his inside hand now brush Fox away, and Fox comes up with the foul.
Nice play from Byron Vaitoe, who will be back with Napier this year in the NBL, which starts on Saturday, the April 9th. We've got a game right here in the ASB Stadium. Caltech Stars hosting North Harbor Vikings. Vaitoe misses his shot. Coming up with it is Derek Martin, former UCLA guard. Goes in quickly. No, off the glass. Vaitoe, rebound Martin.
Well, they've got some quick guys in there now. They really picked up the tempo.
Younger and quicker.
Yeah, exactly. I tell you, we got a little excitement for the fans here. Five lucky fans in the Spalding DB Export shootout at halftime get to throw for $20,000. $20,000.
A shot, a long shot.
Yeah, it's a long shot. It's a three-quarter court shot, but what the heck, you know?
Even if the probability is a million to one.
Yeah, exactly.
Steven Thompson there, left-hander, coming up with it off the glass, makes his first free throw.
Yeah, he's from the University of Syracuse. Great score out of the University of Syracuse. I don't know if he called that bank shot, though.
Makes them both, makes our score 44 to 23 in favor of the Magic Johnson All-Stars. 11 minutes and 10 seconds left in the second quarter of play.
Play a little pinch down, post up.
Byron Vaitoe, no, loses it nearly. Neil Stevens comes up with it. Stevens going in off the glass.
Yes, Stevens.
Interesting contrast with the All-Stars now. They're really double teaming Henry from long range.
Well, Marshall Henry just drops a bomb from three-point land, and we've got...
You'll notice a lot of double teaming, Tom, with this crew here. They're really going to try and strip the ball.
Deny.
Nenad Vucinic to Lamar Jackson.
There you go, Marcel.
Magic Johnson, you may hear him in the background sitting on the bench. He is the player coach of this team.
Stay up there on him.
Vucinic. Chris Tupu going to look for the bomb.
Let's go.
They're going already. He's yelling the go.
Yeah. Derek Martin flips it out to Reggie Fox. Reggie Fox going to look for it. No. Rebound, Steven Thompson. Back out to Marshall Henry. Mike McGee. Henry. No. Chris Tupu bringing it up for AMI, New Zealand. New Zealand team off to Japan in June.
You got to keep your eye on the Magic Johnson All-Stars because they run their lanes well. They're not just running down the floor haphazardly.
Lamar Jackson misses a shot, tipped back out by Vucinic. Chris Tupu comes up with it. Vucinic, the top.
Help.
Jackson.
Get out there.
Stevens.
Help.
Stevens is fouled.
Maybe Thompson doesn't go with that. But, you know, these Magic Johnson All-Stars guys, I mean, they're very good runners of the lane, and they're really looking for the open guy.
Replay.
Neil Stevens at 6'9", and Stevie Thompson at 6'3". You know, pretty much he's going to get the foul on the elbow coming down.
Stevens rims it. Can't make his first.
I think we've got a discrepancy in the score here. It says 41-31. I can't believe that's the score.
No, I think the scoreboard is wrong. And, in fact, when the...
41-21.
Yeah, that's more like it. The All-Stars scored earlier. The Magic Johnson also scored earlier. And I noticed they put some points on the board for New Zealand. After that, it went pretty crazy. I think they're getting it sorted out now. Ross, little one of our three referees here tonight. Ross working with Ken Colson and John Burton is over at the score bench. 9 minutes. You can see our clock there in the top of your screen. 9 minutes, 34 seconds, 41 to 23. We're in the second quarter of play of this Export Gold special on 3 Sport. Great evening. Coming to you live from the ASB Stadium in Koimarama.
Play for one now.
All right. Neil Stevens at the line to take his second shot. Second foul shot goes.
Neil Stevens.
Well, this is the time now that the New Zealand team should take advantage. They should take it out of Cureton. They got a real small team. Biggest guy in the court right now for the All-Stars, 6'6".
They're about six times quicker, too, I'd say.
Yeah, they're a bit quicker.
Mike McGee inside. Flips it out to Marshall Henry. Yes! Yeah. Marshall Henry coming to us from East Carolina University, plays in the CBA with the San Jose Jammers, has played also in South America. I was trying to find out which country he played in. Nobody seemed to know.
Yeah. East Carolina, Jeff Mullins, ex-Golden State Warrior, is a coach there. So he's had some good coaching. That's it. Get the ball inside of Lamar.
Chris Tupu to Lamar Jackson. Oh, yeah.
Jackson.
You know, after what Lamar Jackson has been through, getting dropped by so many teams, this is a great moment for him.
Yeah, no, exactly. Let's see if they do this again now. They should start pounding it down because they got the height advantage at the moment.
I thought that was a nice play inside to Stevens. Stevens going to have a look.
No reach.
And he's fouled.
That's a good play. Get the ball inside.
Yeah.
Foul, 22.
8 minutes, 30 seconds left in the second quarter of play. And we've got the Magic Johnson All-Stars at 45 and the AMI New Zealand All-Stars at 26. 19 points of difference. There's a shot of the Magic man on the bench. He's the player coach of this team and their leader. And they certainly listened to him today at practice. I mean,
he's got such respect, you know. I mean, what he says goes. I'll tell you, Tommy, we're talking about two jet burners in Martin and Fox. I mean, they could turn it on.
Well, Neil Stevens makes his second shot. There's Derek Martin, gets by Chris Tupu. Mike McGee from the corner, yeah.
40.
Mike McGee, former LA Laker. 8 seasons with the Lakers, also played at Atlanta and Sacramento, averaged 9 points a game over his career. Chris Tupu looking again for Lamar Jackson.
Good defense by Stevie Thompson. He three-quartered him on the ball side. Let's go.
Neil Stevens can't make it work. And New Zealand are going to retain possession. 8 minutes left in the second quarter of play. 48-27 in favor of the Export Gold All-Stars. There's their leader, coach, and inspiration, not only to them, but to all of us.
Well, I'll tell you, definitely two different styles. The Magic Johnson All-Stars are now spreading the court. You'll see them next time down. They're driving and kicking it out for the long shot.
Byron Vaitoe at the top. Chris Tupu going to look for a shot. Not going to get it. Lamar Jackson inside. Yeah.
Good play.
Jackson.
Patient.
Lamar Jackson very cool when he gets the ball inside. Nice little fake. Stevie Thompson, he walked.
Yeah, he traveled again. But you notice the All-Stars, they split the side, and they always have a guy cutting down the middle, so that sucks the defense in. And that time the defense just stayed out, and they got the layup down the middle.
50-29, Nunad Vucinic off the glass. Oh, yes.
Great
one-step pump with his right hand. Now, Neil Stevens breaks up a pass here, but the All-Stars, the Magic Johnson. We have so many All-Stars here tonight. Got to sort them out who's who.
Well, it's kind of interesting calling the New Zealand team the All-Stars. They've got a couple of Americans, but essentially it's a New Zealand team.
Yeah, exactly. And we have some changes. Ricky Strother now with Eric Brown.
Ricky Strother
making his first appearance. Eric Brown there on your screen. He'll be appearing with the Caltech Stars in the NBL this year. Derek Martin at the top.
Derek Martin played for UCLA, the Bruins, under the who for a long time dominated under John Wooden, one of the greatest all-time coaches.
Did he play for Wooden?
No, he didn't.
Right.
He played at UCLA just recently.
Hands off. Right. Hands off. There he is, right there. Derek Martin, no. Rebound, Pokai. Peter Pokai to Eric Brown. Eric Brown hustling up, looking for something.
Underneath.
Knocked away, regains his shot. Darren Shaw handling the ball for the first time. Knocks Reggie Fox for a bomb. And look,
Peter Pokai
comes up with it. Now the glass, nice play.
Well, they've got a height advantage now. They're starting to take it inside.
Darren Shaw making his presence felt right away, boom. But of course, now he fouls. It can work against him as well.
Yeah, well, nobody's gonna guard these guys one-on-one. They got too good a step on them. You're gonna have to get some help from your teammate from the side a little bit.
Coach and player Magic Johnson, Irwin Magic Johnson.
Hey, Reggie, get on the
five times NBA championships with the LA Lakers. Ball inbounded. We got Derek Martin at the top. Mike McGee.
Nice pass.
Yeah.
Nice inside bounce pass in the lane.
Steven Thompson with that hoop. Ricky Strother handling it for the first time to Pokai. Pokai going in strong. Knocked away by Thompson. Nice hands, good defense. Derek Martin looking to Mike McGee in the corner. They're always setting somebody in the corner.
They have got the floor mapped out. They know where they're looking at. They know where they're going.
Yeah.
They got definite routes, and it's good open style, NBA style basketball that if you cut off one side of the floor, they're going to thread on the other side.
That was Marshall Henry scoring that last hoop for the All-Stars. Here's Byron Vaitoi. Pokai, Darren Shaw. From New Plymouth, New Plymouth Bears, also a leading team this year's NBL. Here's Eric Brown,
Nice shot, nice shot. That's and here they are right now, ball in the middle, look. Outside weak. Yeah, count it. You know, Ty, it's really interesting to watch these guys because they do spot up. In the NBA, the style of basketball is to spot up your shooters and have somebody cutting to the basket so you've got at least 3 points of attack on offense at all times. And a lot of people think they're just running down there, but they're really going to spots.
And one of those spots is the corners. We have a timeout with 5 minutes, 38 seconds left in the second quarter. It's the Magic Johnson All-Stars, 56th. The AMI New Zealand All-Stars, 36th. We'll be back in just one moment.
Ah,
I miss the battles and the wars, but most of all, what I miss is the camaraderie that I have with the guys, being one of the fellas.
But on the court, Johnson was much more than one of the fellas. Almost single-handedly, he revolutionized the job of point guard in the NBA. At 6'9", Johnson brought passing and scoring skills that the league had never seen in a man of his size. But as tall as he stood on the court, he stands even taller in the eyes of his former coach, Pat Riley.
He amazes me. And all the people who know him and love him and have been around him for years, you know, feel a lot worse than him because we know that it's tough. It's a tough fight.
Johnson first caught the country's attention at Michigan State University, where he led the Spartans to an NCAA basketball title in 1979 as a sophomore. In the championship game against a Larry Bird-led Indiana State team, Johnson scored 24 points in a 75-64 victory.
Coach gave us a good game plan to go against Larry Bird, and all we had to do was go out and do it. And if we did it, he said we would win. That's what we done.
Later that summer, Johnson was the number one draft pick of the Los Angeles Lakers. He quickly made his mark on the league, helping guide his new team to the NBA title in his opening season. Johnson scored 42 points and played all five positions as the Lakers beat Philadelphia 123-107 to clinch the crown. Four more titles would follow that one as Johnson and his Laker teammates reached the NBA Finals 9 times in his 12-year career. Along the way, Johnson won 3 Most Valuable Player awards and was named to the All-Star team 11 times. Throughout it all, his ready smile charmed not only Laker fans, but most of his opponents as well.
Magic is basketball. That's the bottom line. He is basketball. When tough times occurred, he made the game fun. He won championships in carrot. He is basketball. He is what a lot of us is all about.
This past spring, the Lakers met Michael Jordan at the Chicago Bulls in an NBA final that many people tapped the Magic versus Michael show. Chicago came away champs, but Johnson talked of returning to the finals and winning another crown this season. Over the summer, Johnson married his childhood sweetheart, Cookie Lewis, in Lansing, Michigan. She, too, has been tested for the HIV virus, but the result turned out negative. Johnson had missed all three of the Lakers' games so far this season with what had been described as the flu. As recently as Tuesday, Johnson had resumed light workouts and was anxiously anticipating his return to the squad.
You miss being a part of the team, the fellas, and you miss being in the games. You know, you just, this is what you live for. This is what I worked hard for, to get to be playing and not to be watching.
We're back with the action now, and there's the man himself making his second free throw to make it 58-38 in favor of the Magic Johnson All-Stars. 4:45 left in the second quarter. And you know, John, we saw Judd Heathcote, the Michigan State coach, standing with Magic in that clip. I mean, you can tell us a Judd Heathcote story.
Yeah, exactly. The Magic All-Stars are on the run. We've got a fast break here. Nice play, inside scoop. Yeah, Judd Heathcote recruited Magic Johnson when I was on the recruiting wars, and he told me before Magic played his first college game that he had the best guy. I said, who's that? He said, a guy you never heard of, Irving Johnson. I said, you're right. Well, I've heard of him now.
Nice behind the back from Magic, didn't go. Ricky Strother hit a hoop there.
Nice pass.
Darren Shaw has it taken away by Marshall Henry. The All-Stars on the move. Here's the Magic guy back to Marshall Henry. Yes.
Now they got it going now. They put Magic in the middle.
Eric Brown puts away for New Zealand.
Boy, it's up and down now, baby. We're after it.
Rebound, Darren Shaw out to Ralph Lattimore. 4-on-2, here's Eric Brown, jumper, yes.
Eric Brown!
62-44 in favor of the Export Gold All-Stars. We've got 3 minutes and 30 seconds left in the second quarter.
Oh, Peter Polka is putting a pretty good body on Magic Johnson. He's out there at the top trying to guard him. Over the top, it's Stevie Thompson inside, outside to Mike McGee. Head and shoulders fake. Back out to Henry for a tray.
Marshall Henry!
Kind of do it in slide motion at the moment. I think they've got the measure of these guys and saying, okay, this is what I can do.
65-44 in favor of the Magic Johnson All-Stars. We got 3 minutes left in the second quarter. Here's Darren Shaw for New Zealand. Back out to Ralph Lattimore. Eric Brown getting inside. Clips
nice
to Shaw.
Pass.
Yeah.
Nice pass.
Hokai rebound. Block. No.
Fouls on.
Look at him. If he huffs and puffs anymore, he can drive a steam locomotive. I mean, he's really gasping at the moment.
Well, Peter, a minute ago, put his big body into Magic. It was off camera. You didn't see it. It's before we came back. Here's a replay.
There he is. He's gone darn.
Yeah, well.
Look at him. He's sucking right now. He's trying to get that oxygen in.
Magic wondering what kind of foul that was. Nevertheless. Foul shot from Peter Pokai. His first goes down. Pokai bumped Magic a minute ago when Magic had the ball, and of course they had a high five together.
Very
charming.
How many basketball players in the world would like to bump Magic Johnson?
65-45. Pokai puts his second down. 46. 2 minutes, 47 seconds left. Yes.
Yeah. You know what they've done now? They spread the court and put Magic at the high post.
Yes.
The free throw line. Now they've got all kinds of options going for them.
They're using up all the space they've got here. Very clever. Very nice. New Zealand a little bit too tight, John, on offense for me.
Yeah. It's just a matter of a lack of experience of knowing when to take the shot and when not to take the shot. When you're in flow, you take it. Nice pass.
Yeah.
Magic
to Reggie Theus and back to Magic.
They're really playing pretty smart here, actually.
69-46, our score. 2 minutes, 10 seconds left. We're in the second quarter of a play. Here's Pokai. Yeah! No.
Right off the bat, they're looking. There's Magic in the middle. He's got the court spread. Here comes a guy on the right-hand side.
Lester Connor.
That's an ugly shot, I'll tell you.
Earl Curtin rebound, yeah.
Earl Curtin.
Won an NBA championship in 1983 with the Philadelphia 76ers. Finished his career not long ago with Charlotte.
Charlotte Hornets.
Yeah.
Home of the $83 million Larry Johnson.
Yeah. I don't think Earl got that much.
No.
No. There's Eric Brown. Goes inside of Lester Cunningham. Yeah, very nice move. He picks up a foul with a minute and 30 seconds left in the second quarter of play.
We've got some
substitutes for New Zealand.
Kerry Bowagney back on.
Kerry Bowagney, the Jazz man, coming back on. Glenn Denham, our captain, coming back on.
All right, we're playing two.
Lamar Jackson back in the game.
That's the main thing they've got to know. They've got to have confidence in Eric Brown as a point guard that when he gives them the ball, if they've got the shot, they've got to take it.
Yeah.
If he doesn't give it to them, well, then they keep running their cuts. The big difference, you notice when Johnson gives you the ball, the players are really looking to shoot the thing.
Well, Eric Brown misses his first. He makes his second.
Eric Brown.
Magic Johnson bringing the ball up the floor, 71-47. His team in front with a minute 20 left in the second quarter. From the corner, Reggie Theus can't get it over Lamar Jackson. Now hook shot.
Nice hook shot.
Yeah. Bowagney comes
now
up with a loose ball.
Came up limping there on the sideline.
He is limping. Yeah, his knee must be acting up. I think he's probably twisted it again.
He got five boards the first quarter. Look at him, he's struggling right now.
Reggie Theus.
He's not going to give him that one. He got the whole bus ticket that time.
Took some steps before he put to the ball on the floor, and Reggie Theus called for traveling. 71-47, our score, a minute left in the second quarter. Here's Eric Brown to Kerry Bowagney. Lattimore. Glenn Denham, you can watch him move. He's not moving well on that knee.
I think one thing that the New Zealand team is going to have to do, especially when they play the Australians, they're going to have to put some bodies on people on their screens. They're not slamming anybody.
Lamar Jackson, nice fake.
Nice hit, nice fake.
Jackson.
Great. Good head, shoulders fake. Magic down the middle.
Right in the middle. Hook shot.
Whoa. No. Yep, look at him. He's going, darn. That shot goes most of the time.
He knew exactly what he was going to do when he crossed half court as well.
Yeah, he's only, he's right there on the rim.
16 seconds left in the second quarter. Here's Denham at the top for New Zealand. 71-49 in favor of the Export Gold. Magic Johnson All-Stars, ASB Stadium. We're coming to you live from the ASB Stadium, Auckland. Kerry Bowagney off the glass, not going to go. Les John Long with a bomb at halftime. So that's the end of our first half of play. 71-49 in favor of the Magic Johnson All-Stars. Hang in there. We're going to come back.
Ah, dude.
Magic Johnson is more than just a sports hero to America's kids. He's part of their lives. They feel close to him.
I was upset, man, because it's like finding out President Bush got AIDS. It's like so upsetting.
I was upset, so I started crying. So I went upstairs.
I was thinking about what if I had it. If I had a big career like him, what would I do?
And what do you think you would do?
I would try and be spokesperson just like him to help out with AIDS.
Special classes were held to comfort and counsel youngsters.
Has everybody heard of Magic Johnson here?
Yes.
Everybody?
Yes.
The lesson to be learned is about changing behavior, but the focus remained mostly on Magic.
I used to enjoy so much watching him play basketball. I used to just like him so much.
Well, no question. For the kids, that's why I am going to be a spokesman for this HIV virus, because I want them to understand that safe sex is the way to go. I think sometimes we think, well, only gay people can get it, well, it's not going to happen to me. And here I am saying that it can happen to anybody, even me, Magic Johnson, it can happen to.
Welcome back to 3 Sport, where it's halftime in our Export Gold special tonight with the Magic Johnson All-Stars leading the AMI New Zealand All-Stars by 71 points to 39. I think they're just 71-49. They've just taken the score off here at the scoreboard here at the ASB Stadium. Okay, and of course for Magic Johnson, just a couple of years ago, the tragedy was his life was turned upside down when he was tested positive for the HIV virus. How would a man like that, like Magic Johnson, handle the pressure of that sort of news and react to it as well? I mean, he could handle the pressure of being on court, but how could he handle that pressure of news like that? Certainly the toughest challenge of his life.
Ah, dude.
My first reaction was you're devastated, you're upset, you're disappointed. because, you know, why me, so to speak. But then I think the hardest part was actually trying to prepare myself to tell my wife. And I knew I had a baby on the way, and you're worried about whether the baby was safe. So all these things are running through your mind. And so I just got home, and God gave me enough strength to tell her. And I'm just so happy that she's not affected or the baby so far. I never thought it would happen to me. I thought it was far removed from me, from my community, the whole thing. And it has happened to me. And it's happened because I had unprotected sex. And that's why I came out to let people know that it can happen to anybody, you, I, anybody out there as well. What people with HIV virus or AIDS need is support and love. They want people to reach out to them and treat them no different than they treated them before.
All right, so that's Magic Johnson spreading the message at the moment about life being HIV positive. And for their halftime thoughts and also some of the reaction to what's happening at the moment on center court with the Spalding Export Gold shoot for gold, $20,000. There's Tommy Hyde and John Didrik.
Great shootout happening here behind us, John. I mean, ignoring the shootout for a moment, I'm just curious, is the score of this game 71-49 at halftime? Does the result surprise you in any way?
No, it doesn't surprise me at all. I was pretty pleased with the New Zealand effort. They got into flow a little bit and started to take their opportunities. I think they're doing a fine job. They're up against guys that are NBA veterans and some young kids that are from the NBA. So they're doing a fine job. They just have to learn to realize and capitalize on opportunities, not only against an NBA team, but against the Australians, because they've got to beat the Australians to get into the World Cup.
Right, right. Now, is there anything the New Zealand team can do might maybe give them a bit of an advantage at some point?
I think what they ought to do right now, if I was coaching the New Zealand team, I'd pound it inside right now and just really knock those guys around a little bit.
And be physical. Well, you're a pretty physical guy.
Well, I just think that's going to open it up for the other guys. You know, I mean, other than that, you've got to double-team Magic because they get the ball to him.
Right.
Although, I thought that they did a smart job in the second quarter by putting Magic in the middle and splitting the ball to the outside and then letting Magic do whatever he wanted.
Okay,
that makes it really tough.
Yeah. 71-49. We've got 6 minutes left before the start of our third quarter. I'm wondering, you know, in this first half, if you felt like the Magic's All-Stars, were they playing, they weren't playing 100%. Were they playing 80%? How full out were they?
In the second quarter, they got it to about 85% because they get the measure of each player. So they started doing the little cutesy things, the head fakes and kicking it out and taking the outside shot.
All right, those halftime comments there from John Didrik and also Tommy Hyde. Well, of course, it was February 16, 1992 that Magic Johnson decided to retire, but his love of the game, like we're seeing tonight, is so strong, he decided to come back and be part of that infamous team at the Barcelona Olympics. Of course, it was the dream team, and for Magic, it was his chance to get back on the basketball court, and this time, go for gold.
Ah, do.
They've been glorified as the greatest team in history and criticized as millionaires using the games as a personal playground. But they shared in the Olympic spirit just like all the other champions, and if theirs was an unpopular victory, it wasn't apparent anywhere today. And in the manner of men for whom basketball is a job more than a pastime, there was the small matter of unfinished business, the final. Now, the basketball final was the first Olympic event to be sold out, beating even the opening and closing ceremonies. And there was something vaguely ceremonial about today's match. Sure, there was Michael and Magic and Larry on the court, but not all the stars came out to play. Some just came to watch. There was Jack, of course. He's always there. Evander stopped by, so did Spike. And Arnie, all watching basketball's equivalent of Terminator 3. They led 56-42 at half-time and increased the pressure on the Croatians to win 117-85. But statistics just can't tell the full story of their Olympic campaign. Sure, they beat everyone by a lot, but in return, the Olympics got a basketball blessing. And if there was a moment which said it all, it was in the smile of a man whose basketball career became complete today, with the gold medal he thought he might never get the chance to win.
Okay, as you can see, they may not be the dream team here at 94, but I can tell you the Magic Johnson All-Stars are certainly starting to turn it on for the crowd here at the ASB Stadium. We'll take a short break on 3 Sport when we come back. More action in the All-Star game that really is turning out to be magic.
Well, welcome back. We're 30 seconds from the start of our second half, our third quarter of play in this Export Gold All-Star Extravaganza. 71-49, our score in favor of the Export Gold All-Stars. There you can see our crowd. John, I'm curious, what was our scoring in the first half of play?
Well, for the Magic All-Stars, Magic Johnson actually led them with 15 points. He's also the leading rebounder with 8 rebounds. John Long had 11, Marcel Henry had 11, and Lester Connor filled in with 9. On the New Zealand side of the scoring column, Peter Pokai led with 8, Lamar Jackson had 6, Neal Stephens had 6, Eric Brown had 6, Glenn Denham was their leading rebounder with 4, so pretty balanced effort right there. You'll notice the guards have really been taken out of it. I think Nenad Vucinic, a stand-up European player, is not matching the athletic quickness of the Magic Johnson All-Star guy.
Yeah, and in fact, my impressions are that and no disrespect intended, but the entire New Zealand team just isn't as quick as a team as some of these younger players like Lester Connor and others from the All-Star, from the Magic Johnson All-Star team. The quickness has been sort of one of the defining features of the game tonight.
Yeah, quick hands and quick feet. And, you know, you can make up a lot of mistakes with quickness. And for the New Zealand team, they only get one shot at it because they're a little heavier. I'll tell you what, though, if Peter Pokai loses a couple of LBs, he's going to be hell on wheels down in Otago because he's playing pretty good basketball inside.
LBs, we translate that out of dibbiggies, meaning pounds. That's all right. Magic Johnson, there he is, coming up with a tip. We're underway, our third quarter of play. Magic being watched by Kerry Boagne, flips it out to John Long. Long with the first shot of the third quarter, nothing but net.
John Long, tough player. And you can see that they go to John Long. He'll get a lot of shots early, and then it'll start to rotate around. The NBA players have fixed roles as to what they do.
Boagne inside to Denham. Denham is fouled by either Reggie Theus.
Yeah, I think it was Theus.
Theus, all right. Reggie Theus standing before you, very dynamic player in the NBA out of University of Nevada at Las Vegas, came to the Chicago Bulls twice, an all-star in the NBA, and then, of course, got around the circuit, played with a number of teams.
Yeah, it happens to a lot of NBA players. They make a move on a team, and then they start moving around trying to fill a spot, fill a void in other teams. But he is a great player, very dynamic. Not a great jump shooter, per se, but a 6'7 slashing jammer. Magic and Glenn Denham having a little bit of a 2-2 there.
Denham, his second shot, not going to go. I think Glenn is working on a sore leg.
Yeah, he really is. Nice outlet to Reggie Theus, though, inside the curtain.
Lester Connor at the top, back out to the Magic man, who's running the show from the point, one of the greatest, if not the greatest, point guard of all time. NBA career assist leader of all time, Reggie Theus in the corner. Magic, one of the great team players of all time, unlike Michael Jordan, who is more of an individual. Here's John Long.
Yeah, and that was a nice shot by John Long. Exactly. I mean, Michael Jordan is a very individualistic star. Magic Johnson makes you better. He made the other kid from Serbia, Divac. He made him a great player.
Vlade Divac, the center for the LA Lakers still today. There's a shot. Yeah, nice pass from Glenn Denham. Kerry Boagne, great stuff.
Got the All-Star snapping a little bit. Good hustle.
75-51 AMI New Zealand All-Stars still struggling to catch up to the Magic Johnson All-Stars. We have 10 minutes, 20 seconds left in the third quarter of play. And it'll be export gold all-star ball inbounded by John Long, ex-Detroit Piston.
Yeah, it's interesting there. John Long was expecting the referee to flip the ball and keep it going, but you know, the New Zealand referees like to hold on to the leather a little longer.
Inside to Lester Connor, and Connor is fouled by Eric Brown, who put a hand in his face. They're playing the height advantage fairly deliberately here.
Yeah, I think they, you know, kind of picked that out, that Lester had about 6 inches on him, so.
Reggie Theus from the baseline, yes, and he's knocked around by Glenn Denham after the shot.
Yeah, so they'll get possession. But that's typical NBA style of ball. They run the ball. They spot you up, they'll back pick you, and they'll also take advantage of what they consider a mismatch. Here it is right here. Magic goes over the top. He squares up, shoots the ball, and he comes out. You know, maybe Denham was, you know, had a little bit of a gripe there.
Back with the action now. Magic at the top. The Reggie Theus again from the other side. Nice little play, but it doesn't work. Pokai with the rebound. Eric Brown moving up quickly for New Zealand. Glenn Denham in the corner.
Nice
bounce
pass.
Yeah, to Boagie. No, a little bit too fancy.
Yeah, you know, he's battling three guys bigger than he is right there. Nice pull.
Alley-oop did not go to Reggie Theus. It'll be New Zealand ball.
See, Reggie had spotted up, and then he cut to the basket. By that time, the ball was sailing over his head.
Eric Brown coming up with it. Ralph Lattimore inside to Denham. Denham, little hooky, can't go over John Long. Comes up with it. Magic, long pass to the corner, intercepted by Lattimore. Back, nice save. Glenn Denham comes up with it. Denham, Kerry Boagne wide open. Glenn not with his head up.
That's a big difference, not seeing the open players.
Yeah,
I
here mean, he is.
He's been standing there a long time.
Yeah.
Nails it.
Trey Boagne.
Kerry Boagne with a tray. 9 minutes, 20 seconds left in the third quarter. Reggie Theus replies.
Theus,
18 and a half points per career average over, what, 10 seasons in the NBA.
10 seasons. Yeah. Tough play by Eric Brown, but it's not going to go. You know, that's the difference. So people say, look at Magic, they go, what makes a guy so great? What makes him great is that he gets the ball every time, but he doesn't hold on to it too long.
Yeah.
He gets rid of it to the right guy at the right time.
Robust.
And unfortunately for the New Zealand team, a lot of times a little too much pounding of it, a little too much dribbling.
Eric Brown at the top for New Zealand. Glenn Denham, Lattimore. Peter Pokai going to play in Otago this year. Pokai, no.
Good outlet by Magic to John Long, a shooter. Theus is going down.
Magic at the top, nearly triple teamed there at one point. I think they should have closed on him. Maybe something would have happened. Theus over Denham. Yeah.
And again.
And well, he's starting to light it up. See, he's got the hot hand. He's had the last three shots. They've worked him.
Yeah. Boagne from the tray. No. Denham tips it back into the hands of Magic. Magic on the break. Doing
along
a little bit
Cassidy.
Of a hot step. Yeah.
And he puts it down for two.
In all fairness to Glenn Denham, Magic once again is 6'9", 220, and Glenn 6'5", and what, I don't know, 210, 215. It's tough when you've got a 4 or 5 inch advantage. And you're
there we
one,
go.
And,
our Raybach, yeah. Our Raybach replay shows us why he's one of the greatest. I mean, he's got two guys hanging all over him. He still puts up a little left-hander off the glass.
Yeah, you know, it's interesting, Tommy. You watch how many rebounds has Magic got in the last 4 or 5 dimes down. He's got every rebound.
Yeah.
He really has a nose to position. They haven't had to jump for him. The ball's just come to him.
He can't make his foul shot go. Lamar Jackson back in the game comes up with the board. Ralph Lattimore at the side. Neil Stevens
nice
back.
Back
cut. Yeah. Yeah, look at that. Jazz along the baseline.
Nice shot.
Boagne.
Look how quick that ball is out though. Bang, right now. You see how quick they scored? Magic got to half court and they hit John Long going down the middle. 2.5 seconds. And they do it so effortlessly. That's the thing. They just go to spots. Each guy knows where he's got to go. He sees a spot being filled. He takes another lane.
Eric Brown fouling John Long. Long with his first foul shot.
That's Eric Brown's third foul. Although we are playing NBA rules, so he gets three more.
84-56 now our score, favor of the Magic Johnson All-Stars make it 85. John Long. 8 minutes, 13 seconds left in the third quarter of play. It's Eric Brown at the top for the AMI New Zealand All-Stars. Ralph Lattimore in to Neil Stevens. Stevens going to look for it. No, not going to get it.
You know, John Long's playing pretty tough now. They put him on, they put John Long on Boagney, and he's shadowed him all the way down. You know, he's made the last couple buckets, and he's not going to let him get an easy shot this time down.
Earl Curtin there coming up with Magic Johnson. Earl the Twirl. You know, I was trying to find out today how he got the nickname the Twirl. Nobody seemed to know.
Was he a baton player in high school?
Yeah, right. He might have been.
Reggie, you think Reggie's going to shoot it?
No.
He's looking awful hard.
Yeah, he's working at it. Here he goes. My turn, your turn. Here's Neil Stevens out to Boagney. We got a 3-on-2. Jazzman going to pull up off the glass. No. Magic with the rebound.
Good
behind
challenge,
the back.
Him, huh?
Yeah.
Oh! Oh, I tell ya.
Well, Magic goes behind the back, and he's fouled by Kerry Boagney.
Yeah, the Jazz man's a little upset with the Magic foul there. Yeah, here he's coming on his horse. Magic is starting to hop up and down. Nice pick right there.
Yeah.
Ooh, yeah.
I thought it was a nice pick. I also thought he traveled. I don't think you can hop like that, can you?
If you're Magic, you can.
Yeah, right. I'm sorry. I forgot. Here we go. 85-56 our score. Back with the action. 7 minutes and 19 seconds left in the third quarter. It's a great evening of basketball here at the ASB Stadium in Auckland. Reggie Theus inside.
Nice pass
to Earl Curtin. Look.
Good check. Good check. That was Kerry Boagney's fourth foul, so he's got to watch it. Still 7 minutes to go in the third quarter. Nice over the top. Earl Curtin goes in, and Lamar comes right back on top.
Yeah.
Something New Zealand needs right there, a little inside muscle.
Here we go, gentlemen.
New Zealand's been stuck on 56 for a long time now. They've got to throw the ball inside. Let's pound it down the middle and get some flesh on flesh and see if we can get a foul out of it.
Is this wrestling?
Make a call.
Here we are. Big time wrestling. ASB Stadium in Auckland. Export Gold All-Stars led by Magic Johnson got 85 points. While the AMI New Zealand All-Stars have 56, we've got 7 minutes left in the third quarter. Magic Johnson back with
nice
the ball.
Pass.
Yeah, nice pass to Earl Curtin.
Yeah. I'll tell you, Magic's such a great, he just sees so much. I suppose that's why they call him Magic.
Eric Brown, no, inside.
There you go, that's it.
Yeah, there you go. Coach Lamar Jackson doing just what?
He's on his horse.
Says he should do. Magic inside.
Oh! They got him on a charge. Magic got his New Zealand, his first New Zealand charge. All right. Look out. He's going, I don't know about that. He's talking. He's saying, I don't know, man.
That's his second foul. Eric Brown at the top for New Zealand. Play slowed a little bit now. Into half court play. Lamar Jackson spins and shoots. Got a nice shot away, couldn't make it go. Magic Johnson scrambling to come up with it. Pitches out back to Lester Kier. Nice.
And you tell me, Tommy, he had both guys to the side, head fake to the left, and flipped it to the trailer. You're gonna have pretty good vision to do all that on the move.
89-58, it's the Magic Johnson All-Stars by 31. No, make that 29 after a nice hoop from Neil Stevens off the glass. 6 minutes left in the third quarter. Reggie Theus, now. Ball bounced off. No. Yeah, Magic is absolutely right. It did. It bounced off of Lamar Jackson. No way. Shot of Marshall Henry on the All-Stars bench. Magic at the top. Play has slowed now.
He's called play number one, so let's check it out here, see what that is. Looks like a clear out for Lester Connor. Mismatch, 6'4 versus 5'11 inside the curtain. Back out to Magic for a tray, I think.
Yeah.
There you go.
Run for the Magic.
Had to be. He had to hit one.
Well, yeah. After two quarters of play, we've got John Long now on the run for the All-Stars. Pitches back to Magic.
Oh!
Nearly off the...
He's calling for the foul, Ross. Oh, no.
Ralph Lattimore can't make it work. All-Stars running it back. Lester Connor to Magic in the corner. Magic inside, flips it over to Theus. Ball partially blocked, and Lamar Jackson comes up with it. 5:15 left in the third quarter. 92-60, our score in favor of the Magic Johns. All-Stars, Kerry Boagney, no.
Oh, tough shot right there.
Earl Curtin wanting a foul, not going to get it. Lester Connor inside, John Long. Rebound.
He's there. Starting to stretch out a little bit now. Really getting a bit ragged in a bit 94-foot basketball, which is to a disadvantage of the New Zealand team.
Which is why we've got, with nearly 5 minutes left to play in the third quarter, 94-60 our score, and we have a timeout.
Ah, dude.
I'm coming back to the Lakers, and I'm playing again.
Perhaps not as shocking as the announcement, which last November seemed to have taken Magic Johnson away from basketball, but spoken with the same dignity and from behind the same smile. He won't play every game and never on consecutive days, but even courtside, his value to the team is immeasurable. Johnson says his love for the game never really died, he just had to ignore it for a while. But leading the Dream Team to Barcelona gold simply reminded him how much it meant.
Watching as I was just getting better and better, playing hard against them every day, going at it like it was a regular game.
His doctor, though, isn't so sure.
I don't know how to balance the various factors. There's some good, there's some not so good. And in balance, the only thing that we'll know is what happens in this experiment called Irvin Johnson.
Back with our action. There's Magic now sitting out of the game with 4 minutes, 40 seconds left in the third quarter. Nenad Vucinic with a left-handed hook off the glass. That was a bit of a prayer.
Yeah, nice hook though. Bang, quick team in right now. And quick team.
Yeah, Stephen Thompson replies for the Export Gold All-Stars. Makes it 96-62. You know, John, I'm curious for the New Zealand team tonight. Whatever happened to Piero Cameron?
What happened to Piero Cameron? Most valuable Kiwi player in the National League last year. Did a great job against the Australian Junior Tournament last year over in Australia. Got him to the finals. Interesting that he's not there. One of the growing big guys in New Zealand. So it's interesting.
Well, I understood he was on the reserve to play tomorrow night against this team, but he's certainly not uniformed tonight. New Zealand could use him with that strong inside game that they need. Here's Chris Tupu coming inside, flips it back to Byron Vaitoe.
Boy, they're playing against some real quick people right now. Once again, it's all double team, it's all quick hands.
Yeah. Chris Tupu trapped. Nice bounce pass to Ricky Struther, who should be fouled. He is. Reggie Fox or Derek Martin, I'm not sure which one of them hacked Ricky Struther as he went in.
Probably Foxy, the way he's looking as he's coming down. Let's go. Okay, there's Reggie Theus there. He's got his long legs, and Magic's kind of looking over saying, yeah, well, we'll pick it up again in the fourth quarter.
Another night, another victory, maybe. The Ricky Struther puts his first foul shot down, makes it 96-63, but... You know, the Magic Johnson All-Stars, they've played in Argentina, they've played in Germany, they beat the German national team that won the European Championships. And they beat a USA All-Star team. They've won 13 in a row, so I'm told by Lon Rosen, Magic Johnson's agent. Mike McGee coming on there.
Great score in the Big Ten, played for Michigan State. Great player, he's an outstanding shooter.
99-63, Magic Johnson All-Stars looking at a century with 3:50 left in the third quarter of play. Darren Shaw, come on, Darren, take a shot.
Hands off, hands off.
There's Shaw again looking for a strong power play inside. He's slammed, he's actually fouled.
Quick hand, you're going to have to really protect the ball against these guys.
Marshall Henry, we've got a Reebok replay. What is it, John?
Derek is there. Oh, he walked right there. Well, tough call there. Maybe he got him on the arm right there. Yeah, he's kind of signaling for him right at that. But
Darren Shaw, star power forward for the BP Bears from New Plymouth. I'll take the Bears in the Final Four again this year.
Yeah, okay, good call.
Yeah.
Good call. Who would have taken Hunt Valley last year to do anything?
Yeah.
They won it all. Hey, I'll tell you what right now. See, if I, you know, you got to go along with possibly some of your substitutions, but with this team that Magic's got in right now, I'd get the big beefy guys in and really take them to the hole. The biggest guy is 6'6".
Yes.
And that's a game adjustment you got to make.
Derek Martin back out. Marshall Henry back to Martin. Mike McGee can't get a shot. Chris Tupu. Martin in the corner. Martin gives a shot. Ooh.
Well, I hope it'll start getting ticky-tacky here.
Ticky-tacky, you mean the officials?
Yeah, let it flow a little bit. A lot of guys getting a lot of fouls. Reggie Fox has got four fouls.
There's our replay. Picking up the foul. It's Tupu's first. Magic having a breather.
Yeah, he put his shirt on, so you know he's going to rest the next 3.5 minutes.
Player coach Derek Martin, former UCLA guard on the line, makes his first. You know, we don't know much about Martin. I mean, according to the information, other than that.
CBA player, UCLA, great program. They're doing, you know, they've been in the NCAA 64 field the last few years.
Yeah. Nenad Vucinic from Nelson. Played in Nelson.
That's it. Inside. Tried to go for the mismatch, but quickness beat him.
Mike McGee. No. Strother rebound. Long one to Nenad Vucinic. Can't get it.
Look how quick he is.
Yeah,
he is
very
really
fast.
Quick.
Derek Martin pushing his way down to Henry inside. Yeah.
There we go. The Stephen
Thompson.
The
nice
Thompson.
All-time score for Syracuse University, CBA Rookie of the Year at Rapid City, Stephen Thompson coming up with our first dunk of the night.
First dunk of the night.
Yeah. Darren Shaw, nice rebound.
Not finishing off.
Got again, buddy. Yeah. Good. 102 to 66.
Oh, nice pass.
Marshall Henry, here's our replay.
Here's Stevie Thompson jamming at 6'3". Good leaper. Second leading scorer all time at University of Syracuse. Their stadium, University Stadium, holds 32,000, the Carrier Dome.
Syracuse, New York, and they fill it up.
They fill it up every Saturday. Nice back cut by Nenad. Bad pass,
All-Stars. Derek Martin comes up with it, moving it very quickly. He's going to pitch it back to Mike McGee. Inside to
Stevie Thompson. Nice foul. Boy, you can hear that one downtown. Doesn't get it, but it doesn't seem to bother him too much.
Stevie Thompson, former CBA Rookie of the Year. Two in a row. Chris Tupu replies for New Zealand. No, in and out. Rebound. Ricky Strother. Strother.
Side.
Tupu. Up again, Chris. Attaboy. Yeah, off the glass. Nice shot.
Interesting to see what Ricky Strother's doing right now. He hasn't scored too many baskets. You know, a shake and bake player. I've often said I just don't think Ricky Strother has a shot. A shot that he's going to go to. He just takes whatever comes. He doesn't work in a particular move.
106 to 68 in favor of the Export Gold All-Stars. Derek Martin getting away from Chris Tupu. Marshall Henry from Reggie Fox.
Nice play. That strong side, weak side action. They occupied everybody with a dribble, double pick on the weak side, and got clear for the jump shot.
3-on-2 now. Break. Derek Martin to Thompson. Broken up by Nenad Vucinic.
I think I'm really impressed with the way these guys are moving the ball. They do move the ball very well.
The Magic finally gets his timeout. We got a minute left in the third quarter of play. 109 to 68, our score.
From Sport Monthly will be throwing.
109 to 68, our score, with a minute left to play in the third quarter. And, John, I'm wondering if, let me ask you a serious question. With the Americans involved in this game, does that mean the New Zealanders are not getting the experience they ought to be getting, or as a team, or is this good or bad for the New Zealand team to have these extra players in this game? What does it mean?
It's a double-edged sword, Tom. I think it's really good to have a guy like Eric Brown. They need somebody to complement the quickness of the Magic Johnson team to bring the ball up the floor, the experience he's got. I would have liked to have seen Perro Cameron. I think he's an exciting young player that's a very good player. Lamar Jackson, this is an experiment with them because he's now a New Zealander, actually. He's playing the international contest. So I think it's fine from that standpoint. I'm just a little disappointed in probably some of their offensive moves. Like, as I said before, I just don't think Ricky Struthers always seems lost to me out there.
Well, there he is right there, Ricky Strother.
I think he's got tons of talent. I'm not knocking his talent.
Right.
I just don't think he's harnessed it yet. That's
okay. Well, he may be feeling lost, trailing by 31 points, 109 to 68, our score. There's our scoreboard and part of our full house at the ASB Stadium.
Good crowd tonight. Good crowd. Yeah. They're getting into it, and they're seeing a lot of good basketball.
Hands off.
Marshall Henry puts it down, makes it 111-68 in favor of the Magic Johnson All-Stars. Chris Tupu, Canterbury Ram in the National Basketball League, brings the ball up. Darren Shaw back to Lucinic.
Oh, a little picky. Picky. But you see, Stevie Thompson is guarding Ricky Struthers. Stevie's 6'3", Struthers is 6'11". You got to do something with that. You see, the All-Stars, they're taking advantage of mismatches.
Yeah. Ball inbounded, Nenad Vucinic at the top.
Good cut.
Darren Shaw. Darren can make that shot. Vucinic. Nice hoop.
Off the backboard.
Yeah. Little fake cut into the middle, put it up off the glass. Makes it 111-70. 25 seconds left in the third quarter of play. Derek Martin being watched by Chris Tupu. Into the corner, Reggie Fox. Look out.
Oh,
no,
shot.
Short. Struther comes up with it.
Set.
To Tupu. Down the middle, inside to Shaw, not going to go. Yeah, broken up by Fox. Stevie Thompson replies.
Oh, a nice fire. Hoop. That's a great move. Great athletic move. Nice pass.
Yeah.
Nice timing.
Nice hoop to end our third quarter of play. Time runs out. We've got one more quarter to go. The score so far, 113 to that team you're looking at right there. Magic Johnson and his X-Sport Gold All-Stars. There you see our score, 70 to the AMI New Zealand All-Stars. We'll be back in a second. Welcome back. There you see a slow motion replay of our Spalding basketball shot for $20,000. John, it didn't quite get there.
Yeah, he didn't quite have it there, Spanish Johnson, but, you know, good fan there. He's a Laker fan, obviously. He has the gold and purple on. Online, not quite enough muscle, but, you know, good effort for the Spalding DB X-Sport Gold. $20,000. One shot, you never know.
What would he have done with $20,000 anyway, kid his age? Who knows? Spin it all, right.
Went to Disneyland.
Ready to go for our fourth and final quarter. 12 minutes yet to play in this All-Star extravaganza from the ASB Stadium in Auckland. Waiting for the tip-off. John, we've got 36 minutes under our belt. New Zealand kids, you think, feeling a bit weary or
I think
or
they're
not?
Feeling worn down. You're talking about a team of athletes, and they just wear you down. And when you start losing a little bit of your fitness, your athletic skill drops, and the New Zealand kids have dropped a lot more than Magic Johnson All-Stars, which is to be expected. But, you know, still, it's a 43-point difference right now, which, yeah, I suppose that's the way it should be, you know? I mean, these guys are some of the best players going.
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen.
Derek Martin at the top for the All-Stars. Marshall Henry, Magic Johnson not
nice
on the
back
floor
pick.
Right now. Oh, yes!
Yeah.
Our play of the game.
Thompson right there. Nice back pick over the top. Crowd's going nuts right now.
Well, we've got to see a Reebok replay on that one. Lamar
Great
Johnson
play.
At the other end. Lamar Jackson at the other end is fouled. Here
okay.
we are.
Let's Here comes a Reebok replay. It's Stevie Thompson over the top. You got to remember, he's only 6'3". He had both elbows above the rim. Great play, and actually a great play because it's great communication of timing. Because the pass was excellent. The pass was right up there.
It was a terrific pass, actually, and of course, our outstanding shot of the game, in my opinion. Here's Lamar Jackson at the other end. His first foul shot goes.
Play one, Black.
Sexton, I think one of the things you got to realize, I mean, and some of these guys have been in the NBA a long time, and they're a little past their prime, but NBA players can score. If you don't guard them, they're going to put the ball in the basket.
Lamar.
Yep, got a little bit of a chicken step in there.
Serious
a little bit of a quick step.
Collision. Lamar Jackson ends up on the floor. Lamar Jackson going to appear for the North Harbor Vikings in the National League later this year.
That's good, though. Lamar's the first guy to put anybody down.
Yeah.
Well, you gotta show your authority out there a bit. You can't let people walk over you. Nice back cut by Byron.
Yeah, Byron by Toey with a turnaround. Reggie Fox goes down. He's all right. He gets up 74, our score in favor of the Magic Johnson All-Stars. Sponsored by DB X-Sport Gold. Derek Martin at the top.
Do they got enough signs in the stadium?
Yeah. Yeah, you certainly this thing is sponsored. Marshall Henry, nice turnaround jumper from 12 feet. Nothing but net, 117-74. Ralph Lattimore replies, Lattimore could take more shots.
You know, Ralph hasn't even looked at the basket. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about, yeah. Knowing your role and when to shoot and when not to shoot.
Yeah.
He's almost like a liability out there.
Yeah, well, he's a good shooter, and he's just not doing it.
Excellent shooter, but if you're not going to shoot, defense is going to play off you.
Derek Martin comes up with a loose ball, runs it down all alone. No.
He's quick.
Yeah, very quick. Outlet pass to Byron Vitoe. He'll pull up, shoot the J. No, he was fouled by Mike McGee.
That was what you call a hammer foul.
Yeah.
Mike didn't jump. He just lowered the boom. But, you know, the difference, too, also, I mean, even though, you know, New Zealand's, you know, got their best athletes out here, they're still playing just a bit below the rim or at rim level, whereas the Magic Johnson All-Star guys are playing about 2 feet above the rim and creating a lot of airspace. Big difference in the game of basketball.
Byron Vitoe drops his first one. It's his second, 117-75. No, doesn't go. 10 minutes, 20 seconds left in this game. We're in the fourth quarter. Magic Johnson All-Stars moving the ball up slowly. Marshall Henry getting by Lamar Jackson. And that's, fouled by Ralph Lattimore.
That's one of those moves where you say the guy left his jock strap on the floor because he kind of hesitated, went one way, faked and came back.
Absolutely.
And Lamar didn't move. You know, Byron Vitoe doesn't have any points, you know, in the first half. I mean, so some of the scores for the New Zealand team, you know, they got to front up and put the ball in the hoop.
Our Raybach replay showing that foul there that sends Marshall Henry to the free throw line. He makes his first.
This kid on the line right now is a fringe NBA player, played in the CBA, and probably had a look at the NBA, but he wasn't quite making the grade, and he's a fine player.
Played with the San Jose Jammers back at the other end, Lamar Jackson, yeah.
Jackson for two.
Just under 10 minutes to play, 118-78 our score, and play has slowed down considerably. Steve Thompson now, the quick guy at the end, gets by Ralph Lattimore. Nice bounce pass in the corner, Reggie Fox.
Bang, oh. Had the look.
No, not a good pass.
You know.
Eric Brown comes up with it and scores his own.
Good play there. But not a good pass because Darren Shaw is not the guy you want to handle the ball 20 feet from the hoop.
Yeah, exactly.
He's a low post guy.
Right, exactly. Good call. 118-80 in favor of the DBX Sport All-Stars. Magic Johnson hands on his head.
Yeah, but you notice how intense his eyes were? Derek Martin right to the basket. He is so quick. But, you know, Magic, you know, it's interesting watching him coach, you know. I mean, he's real. I'm impressed with the amount of plays these guys have run.
Hands off. One.
Back at the other end, Lamar Jackson to Byron Vitoe. Eric Brown, Lattimore. Lattimore finally getting a shot right away. No. Partially blocked. Goaltending.
Yeah, he caught that. That was a tough one. Stevie Thompson is really a flyer. He got the bottom part of the ball. You know, I still think it was going up on
I
that.
I do too, but, yeah. You know. I agree. Nevertheless, New Zealand needs every point they can get at this stage. They're trailing 82-120.
Hands on the back.
Reggie Fox is inside, and he's fouled by Byron Vitoe. 8 minutes, 42 seconds left in the fourth and final quarter of play.
Just kind of toying with him right now, letting the guards go one-on-one, collapsing the defense. They'll either take it all the way to the basket or they'll kick it out for a jump shot from the outside.
Magic, nah, they're not doing what he wants.
I think he's trying to get these guys to run some plays because they're going to stay together and play a lot of different teams.
Yeah. Yeah, doesn't want it to get sloppy by any stretch. Stevie Thompson puts it in, but it's not going to count. It's a foul before the shot.
That's interesting. One of the things you tell a kid as a coach is not to leave your feet to pass the ball. But I'll tell you, they've got so many options when they take off.
In play.
And we got
Neil
Finn back there. Hey, Mike, I was going to get to it. We got Neil Finn back there, crowded house. He's got his camera out.
Nice shot from Reggie Fox along the baseline. Neil Finn, a great Lakers fan, and of course it's been said that Magic Johnson is a mutual fan of Crowded House. So Neil was here with his boys today at the workout. They're all dressed in Laker gear.
Hey, well, you got to go with the flow when you're from Hollywood, baby.
122 to 82. It's the Export Gold All-Stars, coached and led by Magic Johnson, leading by 40 points. We've got 8 minutes left to play in the fourth quarter.
Oh, yeah!
What was that?
That's what you call pulling one out of your backside. He nailed it, though.
Fall away jumper from Marshall. Henry makes it 124-82.
Here it is. Here's right that. Here, the replay. Yeah. That's what you call a fadeaway, folks, from downtown.
Incredible.
Great shot by Henry.
Nice hoop at the other end. Mike McGee can't make it go. Lamar Jackson with the rebound. 7 minutes, 30 seconds left to play in the game. 124 to 84.
Oh, nice pass.
Yeah, it was a nice pass.
What do you say, Tommy? You think Mike McGee, number 40, has the smallest steps of anybody in the NBA?
I haven't actually had a good look at it yet.
Oh, just watching him run up the lane. Now, you know, he takes what we call Chinese steps, little tiny ones.
Very short shuffle. You might watch out. You might be banned from television staying there.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. Get that commercial off the air.
There's Mike McGee on our screen right now. Mike, of course, played with Magic Johnson, the LA Lakers. He holds a couple NBA championship rings.
Great scorer out of the University of Michigan.
Yeah, exactly right. He's played in Italy and France as well, I understand. Stevie Thompson inside, double team. Hips it back out to McGee. Marshall Henry.
Yeah, look, nice pass. You've got to clap your hands on that. That's great ball movement and body movement. They had it all synchronized for an all-star game team to do that. You got to take your hat off. That's great. That's good basketball.
Lamar Jackson.
Here it is right there in the corner. Back inside to Stevie Thompson. Bang. Reebok replay.
White substitution. Seven is Magic.
1-8.
Back with the action. And the cheering you hear, of course, is for the return of the Magic Man. We've got 6 minutes, 48 seconds left to play. Other substitutions. Neil Stevens back in for New Zealand.
Okay, we got Neil Stevens and Ricky Struthers, and see what, and Lamar Jackson. I mean, that could be a possible front line. See what kind of combination they can work.
You know, it's interesting you should say that, John, because I don't know that there's been a combination here.
No, there really hasn't been any coordination amongst the big guys.
Yeah. Lamar Jackson inside. Have a good night. Look at this. No, yeah.
There they go. All right.
Yeah, there you are.
You got Struthers and Neil on both sides. 6'9", 6'11".
Each of them got a piece of the ball. 126 to 86 in favor of the Magic Johnson All-Stars. 6:29 left. Mike McGee can't get a shot.
Well, we should say it's early in the season for New Zealand, and this has got to benefit them as a team.
Magic with a three-pointer. No,
short. Got the bottom part of the ring on that one. Comes right off the bench, though, not warmed up yet.
Ninad Vucinic off the glass. Nice bounce pass from Eric Brown. Marshall Henry.
Yeah, he's got the hot hand right now.
Marshall Henry.
Well, I'll tell you what, they cut it to 41.
5 minutes, 53 seconds, you old cynic here. 5 minutes, 47 seconds now. Look at that.
Henry likes that spot. Now, what do you think he might spot up there again the next time down?
Ninad. Yeah, the other end, giving him the shot off the glass. Nice shot, Ninad Vucinic.
The thing is, though, when you're down 44 points, why are you faking a 12-footer?
We have a turnover from the All-Stars. And a long horn. Which is either substitutions or no, we got a substitution. Kerry Bowagney coming back in for New Zealand. On your screen, you see Marshall Henry, who has hit three of the last four hoops for the All-Stars. Some spectacular shooting going on here in the closing minutes of this game. 132 to 90, our score in favor of the Magic Johnson All-Stars.
Kind of schoolyard ball there. Your turn, my turn.
Right. It is. It's getting loose.
Yeah. Neil Stevens.
Nice shot. Doesn't go. Henry with the rebound. Stevens going to come up with it. He's probably going to put it right back. And, well, the Jazz man inside going to go strong. He was fouled. No call.
Whoa, he got
Mike McGee hammered him. Yeah. Magic inside. Double pumps off. Oh, not quite.
Yeah, Magic's just been a shade off probably tonight.
Ninad, no.
Yeah. Replay. Nedved comes in, the ball's off the rim. Here's Struthers, jams it down.
Very nice. Reebok replay, Ricky Struthers. Yeah, I would too. Chris Tupu with a shot. Back with live action. Yes.
All right, Neil Stevens coming up with a big steal. Double dribble, no problem. Has it on Gary Millar, didn't count it.
Well, you can dribble your hand with your ball with two hands in an all-star game, I guess. 4 minutes.
Magic Johnson going to the basket.
Yeah. Back out to Henry. Here's our bomber.
That's about a 40-footer shot right there. That was beyond the NBA 24-foot line.
Terrific shooting exhibition from Marshall Henry. Makes it 137-96 with 3 minutes and 50 seconds.
Marshall's racked up 29 points.
Neil Stevens replying from the corner. You know, the score. Oh, look, Mike McGee. No. Woo. Stevie Thompson takes it away from Neil. Nenad with an interception. Chris Tupu all alone.
The other
end.
Tupu, run away.
No jam from Chris Tupu.
All right, 137-100. 3.5 to go. Magic's going, what can I do here? Oh, a couple bad passes. The Zealand team can make a run.
Chris Tupu off the glass. Nice pass from Perry Boagne. 102 now for the AMI New Zealand All-Stars, 137, the Expo Gold All-Stars. John, the score may be a great difference, but this is a great game.
It's been an up-and-down game, and people have, found out some things, I think. I've been impressed with the All-Stars, just with their organization, and I've been impressed with certain elements of the New Zealand team. They've got the goods, they just got to put it together.
Magic with a long bomb, not going to go. Reggie Fox is in there for two tips.
Well, I'll tell you.
He gets the second. Chris Tupu now bringing it up for New Zealand. He's the smallest man on the floor, and tonight, one of the best in my opinion.
Yeah, he's had a very good game. You know, he's taking the ball to the basket.
Nenad with a baseline jumper. Can't make it go. Struther with a rebound. Yeah, taken away. Stephen Thompson going all the way.
He's a great player, Stevie Thompson.
Stephen Thompson.
Good leaper.
2 minutes to play in our All-Star extravaganza from the ASB Stadium in Auckland. 141-102, our score in favor of the Export Gold All-Stars. Neil Stevens, no.
Sucking a little air at the moment, some of the big guys.
Last 2 minutes to go.
Magic Johnson flips it out, intercepted by the Jazz man.
That's Bill
Tupu,
up, ladies and gentlemen.
3-on-1, 5-on-1 situation.
Bank
Chris
shot.
Tupu, off the glass.
It's good.
Nice shot.
Good. That's five.
1:35 left to play. Magic Johnson at the top, being looked after by Nenad Vucinic. Inside to Stevie Thompson. Nice pass.
Oh, Stevie Thompson's done a great job at 6 threes. Too quick for Struthers in there.
Yeah, too quick. He's got a terrific leap. 1:20 left to play in the game. 143-104 our score. Neil Stevens. Nice.
Hooks over the Magic man. Good shot.
Reggie Fox, no.
On the line, out there.
Becoming a bit of a shooting exhibition here in the last few minutes. 105 left to play, just over a minute. 143-106 our score. Chris Tupu at the top for New Zealand. Struther to Neil Stevens. Stevens going to look for it. Yeah, Hooker.
Yeah, he's got the Magic man up. Doug couldn't quite get that one to fall.
And nearly got the tip, doesn't go. Magic man comes back up with it. Irwin Magic Johnson pulls up from 40 feet.
Yeah.
Got the big one he's been looking for here. 30 seconds
there
left.
There it is. Reebok replay. Magic Johnson straight down the gut. 45 feet. Count it. Twine City. Oh! Coming back. Ricky Struthers just jams another one.
Final 15 seconds of the game. Magic Johnson again. A shooting exhibition that's not going to work. Second time. Back out to Mike McGee. Magic.
They go back to the Magic.
One more shot. Get Nenad out of there. Give him a shot for Pete's sake. 4 seconds to the hook. No.
Oh.
Our hook shot misses the game. Neil Stevens and Magic. A nice hook. Here's Mike McGee. Our final score. Standing ovation from our full house for Magic Johnson and his All-Stars. They win it 146 So 108, there's your score. And of course, look at the kids on the floor. Everybody after.
Oh, autograph. Yeah.
It's autograph time.
I think they're going for one guy. They're trying to get near the NBA guys. Magic Johnson waving to the crowd. Put on a really good exhibition, you know? Magic Johnson's bodyguard in the camp right there. John, Tony somebody. He's his personal bodyguard. Great exhibition, though. I think the New Zealand team did all right. I think they learned some things out of that.
Terrific tribute from our full house here in Auckland for Irwin Magic Johnson. His first of two appearances in New Zealand and perhaps his only appearances in New Zealand. It's been a pleasure.
Yeah, no, it's been an honor for me to call a game. A few years back, you and I, Tommy, called the first Russian Soviet Union USSR game against an all-star team. And, you know, we've been real fortunate tonight to see the Magic Man in Auckland.
Nice to have you with us. 146 to 108, our final score.